6 o'clock silence of a new day beginning is heard in a small Texas town. Like a signal from nowhere, the people who live there are up and moving around. There's bacon to fry, there's biscuits to bake. On a stove the Salvation Army won't take. You open the window, then you turn on the fan, 'cause it's hotter than hell when the sun hits the land. Walter and Fanny Day, why they own the grocery, they sell most all that you need. They've been up and working since early this morning. They got the whole village to feed. They put out fresh eggs, they put bad ones away, the ones that rotted because of the heat yesterday. The store is all dark, so you can't see the flies that settle on round steak and last Monday's pie. Sleepy Hills Drugstore and the cafe, well, they're both open today, and the coffee inside is bubbling hot. The folks who ain't working, why, well, they'll sit there till sundown. They talk about what it is they ain't got. Somebody just blew a clutch in the old pickup truck, and it seems like they've been riding on a streak of bad luck. The doctor bill came and the well has gone dry. Seems their grown kids don't care whether they live or die. I can recall when Kopperl, Texas was a good place for man to live and raise a family. Been a long time ago, though, back before the cotton gin closed down. Still, some folks around the town, they recall the day that Steve Hughes, he lost his arm in that infernal machine and walked all the way home, bleeding to death. Then back in the early 1950s, it was Army Corps engineers. They come down and dammed up the Brazos River, not too far from Kopperl, and built Lake Whitman. After the highway folks improved the road to the lake, folks came down from Fort Worth and Dallas and up from Waco, see what the fishing was like. Sure has been quiet in Kopperl since the Santa Fe Railroad. They closed down the depot and they built a brand new trestle out west of town. Now the train, why, it don't stop here anymore. Now the train, it don't stop here anymore. Where my aunt bought me some ice cream, and my mom was there to meet us when the train pulled into Kopperl. But now kids at night, they break the wind, the lights and the sound. The train's only remains in the memory of the ones like me who have turned their backs on the splintered cracks in the wall to stand on the railroad man where we used to play, and then a runaway the depot man. Run away, Jimmy, from the depot man. We ran away as fast as we can. Run away. The train, it just don't stop here. Anymore. I remember me and brother, we used to run down to the depot just to listen to the whistle when the train pulled into Kopperl. In the engine, big and shiny, black as coal, it fed the fire. In the engineer, he'd smile and say, howdy, how you fellas.
furniture cracks in the wall to stand on the railroad land where we used to play. And then I run away from the depot man, run away from the depot man.
Run away, Jimmy, as fast as you can.
And we ran away. Wonder why it is you don't see too many young folks around Kopperl these days. Seems like soon as the last part of May rolls around and the seniors who do graduate, you know, they run off to Cleburne or Fort Worth, you know. They get them a good job, you know, depending, of course, on what it is they know, you know. They go to work for the cement plant there in Cleburne or the telephone folks in Fort Worth if they can climb worth a damn. Then there's some don't leave Bosque County, Texas at all, except perhaps for groceries. They live there, they die there, and when they do die, they haul them down to Meridian, Texas, where the funeral home is, and they lay them out in state. And the funeral homeowners come by, and they cry, they cry, they cry. The next day, about 2 o'clock, big old white hearse hauls the body back up to Kopperl, Texas, laid out in state at the Methodist Church or the Baptist Church or the Church of Christ, any one of the big three there in Kopperl. And then the Reverend Brother something or other says the godlike words, and it finally comes time to view the body. And ever since the drive-in movie closed down, viewing the body is a highlight of a weekend there in Bosque County, Texas. The last funeral I went to, I was a pallbearer. Perhaps that's the reason it was the last funeral I went to. Spent the whole day with the body in my mind. Didn't have much to say. But when they view the body, the folks in Bosque County got strange things to say. Things like, my, my, don't he look natural? Or, looks like he'd sit right up and talk to you, don't he? Or, looks like he's asleep. Or, the funeral home sure did a fine job, didn't he? Tell you what, friend, they always look just deader than hell to me. Well, Mary Martin was a schoolgirl, just 17 or so, when she married Billy Archer about 14 years ago. Not even out of high school, folks said it would not last. But when you grow up in the country, grow up mighty fast. And they married in a hurry in March before school was out. Folks said, why hell, she's pregnant, you just wait and you'll find out. It came about that winter, one gray November morn. Well, the first of many more to come, a baby boy was born. Cattle that his daddy could afford. I seen him bouncing across the cactus in 1954. But the cows was sick and skinny, and the weeds was all that grew. And Billy, he kept the place alive, was the only thing he knew. And Mary cooked the supper, and Mary scrubbed the clothes. Horses and she blew the baby's nose. And Mary and a shotgun kept the rattlesnakes away. Oh, but how she kept on smiling, what nobody could ever say. And cattle is their game, and Archer is the name they give to the acres that they own. If the Brazos don't run year from Mary will have. the drought that ended in 1957 was a curse upon the land. Wasn't nobody in Bosque County, Texas, able to give Bill a helping hand. And the ground was cracked and broken, and the truck was out of gas. And the cows can't feed on prickly pear instead of growing grass. And the weather, it got the water, and a snake bite took a child. And a fire in the old barn took the hay that Bill had piled. And the mortgage got the money, Lloyd, and the screw worm got the cow. Well, the years have come to Mary. She's awake. Silence of a new day beginning is heard in a small Texas town. Like a signal from nowhere, the people who live there are up and they're moving around.